While most wool leaves the state, there's a growing market for some to stay right here in South Dakota. Brenda Anderson is the owner of Busy U Farm and Fiber, proprietor of hand-dyed wool, and caretaker of a production crew that consists of a rare breed of long wool sheep.
South Dakota is more of a commercial sheep area. And so with the long wool, we don't fit in that little square box. You're having people that want to do hand spinning, or if they're wanting the sheen for dyeing or something like that. You know, if you're doing needle felting. I've always been fascinated by spinning. I finally learned how probably about 2008. And so then I started looking for fiber, and I found out I loved to spin. So then it was like, okay, where am I gonna get fiber? So then I bought sheep. We had never raised sheep, so I didn't know if I'd like it or not. My grandfather raised cows, and so he was a cattle rancher, and he always called them pasture maggots. So we didn't have a very good connotation with sheep, and so I wanted the wool, and so I thought, well, I'll get some sheep and see if I like it or not. And I was just totally amazed when we first got the sheep. I discovered it. I love sheep. They're with my friends, they're part of the whole business, you know, so they all have their own names, they all have their own personalities. So then I started learning about the Teeswater. They have the longer staple, but they don't have the thick lanolin that some of the other ones do. And for hand spinning, because of the longer staple length, I find it easier to spin. With the Teeswater, they tend to grow up to an inch a month. This is 1 year of growth. And I fell in love with the locks. And then we started dyeing, and people asked me to start doing it for other people. And it just kind of keeps snowballing. And people kept saying, well, why don't you ever finish products? And I said, well, I raise the sheep, I wash the fiber, I made the yarn. I figured you could finish the product. And so they've talked me into finishing some things. So we do knitting, crocheting, spinning, and also some weaving. We have a small farm, less than 10 acres. So I couldn't have a lot of animals. But I thought, if I do this, I can help save the genetics. In England, they are a dual purpose animal, so we also use them as such here. You know, you can use their fiber. The meat is wonderful. And you can even use sheep for milk.